three recent reports on the Second Amendment should cause us worry. The attack on the Second Amendment continues without any pause whatsoever. For example, let's start with most recent examples of mass shootings: Sutherland Springs, Texas, on November 5, and Las Vegas on October 1. In both of these cases, as well as all of the others in the last several decades, the first words out of the mouths of liberals are gun control. So, how does gun control fare in Chicago, which has some of the most stringent gun laws in the country and a city that has the highest death rate due to gun violence in the country? In just 2017, 586 persons have been killed and 2,786 wounded in that city. That averages out to 48 dying with 232 wounded each month of this year so far. And in early December, 1 people were shot, with three of those who died. Yep, gun control really works, doesn't it? Regardless, here are three recent reports of gun control that might cause us worry. The first report occurred in 2012. The plaintiff in the case, Dale Norman, was arrested in February 2012, in Fort Pierce as he openly carried a gun in a holster. In Norman challenged the constitutionality of the state's long-standing ban on openly carrying weapons. But the state's 4th District Court of Appeal and the Florida Supreme Court ruled against Norman, leading him to go to the U.S. Supreme Court. On Monday, November 27, 2017, the U.S. Supreme Court refused to hear the case, thereby leaving Norman's conviction in place. Now, one could argue that this was a state issue regarding open carry, but this is still a blow against the Second Amendment. The second report is even more egregious. The Honolulu Police Department issued a directive that has decided that all medical marijuana users must surrender your firearms. Kit, a local TV station, reported. In a letter dated November 13, new Chief of Police Susan Ballard states cardholders have 30 days to surrender weapons, permits, and ammunition to HPD or to transfer ownership. According to the letter, the only way cardholders can get their weapons back is to get clearance from their doctors. Now think about this for a moment, the report states. Not only is this a violation of the Fifth Amendment's protections, but since when did cops get to make such a decision? Damn, well said and straight to the point. Now the kicker is the third report. 16 retired military leaders have drafted a letter to Congress urging them to take action to pass more gun control laws so as to address the national crisis of gun deaths and violence. They claim that by not passing needed gun control laws that Congress is no longer speaking for the majority of the American people, but many will argue that point. Obviously those generals are out of touch with we the people, that is we deplorables. The attacks on the Second Amendment will continue. But, hopefully, sane heads will continue to succeed in keeping them in check.